Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty McKean from Nao Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you a cool underlay design using gels and metallics. So I'm going to start by showing you how to create this design. So this is going to be the first one of the three. When I first saw this kind of thing, I thought it was all done on top of the nail, but it's not. It's done underneath the nail. So imagine you would do this on a clear free edge. So you couldn't do it on a natural nail. You would have to do it on either a clear sculpted out nail or a clear tip. You could do this in hard gel or acrylic. We're going to turn the nail upside down. I'm just going to pop it on my little stand here. And we're going to work on the inside, so it could only be done on the free edge of the nail. You couldn't do it, obviously, where there is a living finger. We will need Mega Gloss. You can use the Urban Graffiti gel polish top coat, however it works so much better with Mega Gloss, and that's because Mega Gloss is thicker. You can do this with a builder gel if you want to as well, but I find that Mega Gloss is perfectly fine to do this design. So I'm going to use the backing paper from the sculpting form. I'm going to pop some of the Mega Gloss onto there. A little pool of Mega Gloss. And you're going to pick up some of the Mega Gloss. Now if you look at this one, I want you to look at this first so you can see exactly what we're going to do. Can you see how this drip is a different shape to some of the others? You've got some of them kind of like teardroppy kind of shapes. They're not just circles. I find that that added a little bit more interest. So I'll show you how to do that. So first of all, you're going to add some random drips. I like to get some normal random drips laid out first. And then you can start putting smaller drips in the gaps. And then what we're going to do to create them other shapes is add a little drip to that one, which makes that a little bit of a different shape. And we're going to do it on this one here. I'll do it a bit slower so you can see. So that creates a different shape there. I'm going to add some little ones towards the edge because we want the full design go from edge to edge. I think we have enough there. I'm going to pop that into the lamp and cure that. So you can see all the drips. And what they're going to do is they're going to cause shading and highlighting because they are three-dimensional. And what we're going to use, we're going to use the same colours that are on this one, because I know you'll all be saying, well, what colours are they? They look really pretty. And I'll show you what colours they are. So we've got these three here, just going to move them out of the way. I love these metallics, they're like my new favourite thing in the world, apart from unicorns. So we've got this hot pink, and that is the number to that colour. And we've got a purple, which is that colour. Obviously all these will be in the description box below, so don't worry if you think, oh, I forgot what colour that was. They'll all be in the description box below, and then you've got this sort of teal colour as well. I'm going to open my lids, and I'm not going to knock them over. If you knock these bottles over, the liquid will spill out very, very quickly. With normal gel polish, it's thicker, so it won't. Whereas this is really... So I'm going to start with the pink at the top. We'll do a few layers of this to build up a bit more colour. So you're going to do it nice and thin at first. And then we're going to go with the purple. You want those colours to merge together, so it's important that they're wet. And then as the brush touches it, make sure you just give that a bit of a clean before you put it back in. And and we're going to let them dry. So now that's dry, I'm going to go in and do a second coat. Oh, I nearly knocked that bottle then. Oh my God, I'm so clumsy. So I'm creating a bit of an ombre from colour to colour. So it is important that each colour is still wet and merges into each other to give you that effect. And if you're not happy with the blend, you can always go back over and add a bit more. It's better to do more thin layers than thick layers. So you can see the difference between it being dry and wet. I'm going to seal this because obviously if this is under the free edge, it needs to be sealed. And I'm going to seal it with the Urban Graffiti top coat because this is thinner and I don't want to lose the definition of the design. When you're sealing it, make sure you don't flood it too much. You will need to, you know, go right to the edges. You know, treat it as if it is on top of the nail. I'm doing a full nail just for your benefit so you can see the full effects. I'm going to cure that in the lamp now. So that's what it looks like from the top. So you can see it picks up all those three dimensions. It kind of makes your brain go a bit weird because it does mine. Oh, mine's a little bit weird anyway, but it makes you go, wow, how's that done? It makes you actually want to touch it because you feel like you could touch it and they would be on the top, but they're not. They're underneath. I'm going to show you a few more designs now of how you can use this technique to create different looks. With this one, I'm going to create some love hearts. And what I'll do is I will cure when I'm happy with the shape. So this kind of thing is going to take a little bit longer than the droplets. This is just to show you that you can get a bit creative. So when you're happy with that, I'm going to cure that now. I don't have to give it a full cure. I can just give it a flash cure just so it stays still because it's concaved and it's in this sort of well. It looks like the bottom of a boat. It obviously will move. So I want to cure that just to give it a bit of a freeze. So we've got the hearts on now. I'm going to use the black and the red. We have a few different reds. This is that red. And then we've got the black metallic. And I'm going to seal that same as I've done the other ones with the Urban Graffiti gel polish top coat. I like the black, how they're quite hidden, but then the light catches it and you can see it. How cool is that? Then I'm going to do another one on this one. This is a shorter tip, so I want to show you that you can do it on shorter nails. Because I know you're all thinking, well, that's on a full nail, and we can only do this on the free edge. So I've just gone down a scale as well. On this one, we're going to go a little bit more intricate. So we're going to use some rose gold metallics now. These are absolutely amazing. And those that know JJ, one of our models, she is obsessed with these colours. So we've got this, which is more of a silvery with a slight pink to it. And then we've got these two rose golds. I'll show you. So that's that rose gold. And then the pinkier one, this is more pinker, this one is. And that is that colour. So we're going to use this one as well. 1111. No, 111. That's it.
111,
yeah. Too many ones there. So you can see from doing this underlay effect, you can go from doing something really simple and really effective to doing something a little bit more detailed. So you can really stretch your abilities and go for it. And then just look at that. I love this. I love this so much. I love that little sneaky heart there that you can only see when you rock the nail. But this is my favourite. Maybe because it's a bit more detailed, I don't know. Maybe it's because the colours are so gorgeous. So you can see we've got some roses here, some stencil roses, and then we've got little buds here and some swirly bits and leaves. You can really go to town if you want to, or you can do something simple, like the little drips. They also look very, very effective. So there you are, a really easy, simple design using the underlay technique. Underlay, underlay, arriba, arriba! Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Check out the, what's it called? Information box. No, what's it called? Description box for all of the products we've used today. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye! Do you think it's just so nice? It's so cool, that, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really nice.
I'm sorry, you just don't get excited like I do. I'm sorry.
I'm a man.